Hello learners, welcoming you all. Here is my new video with the chapter Physical Quantities and Measurement. In this video I have tried to explain density and relative density. So let's see, what is density? Density of a substance is defined as the mass per unit volume of that substance. So what is the formula of density? Density is equals to mass upon volume. In short, we can write it like D is equals to M upon V. Then how we can get the unit of density? For that, you just think about the formula of density. If formula of density is that it is equals to mass upon volume, it means unit of density will be what? Unit of mass upon unit of volume. So what is unit of mass? That is kg. And what is the unit of volume? It is meter cube. So overall, what is unit of density? It is kg per meter cube. Here I am talking about SI unit. If we will discuss about CGS unit, in CGS unit, unit of mass is gram and unit of volume is centimeter cube. Hence, unit of density in CGS system is gram per centimeter cube. For example, if someone will tell me that density of brass is 8.4 gram per centimeter cube, what does it mean? How I will explain that person? I must say that it means that 1 centimeter cube volume of brass has mass 8.4 gram. Okay? Now, what is the relation between kg per meter cube and gram per centimeter cube? I have explained this relationship with the help of one example, and I have taken example of density of water. We knew that density of water in CGS system is 1 gram per centimeter cube. I am talking about a particular temperature, and temperature is 4 degrees in Celsius. So what is the density of water in CGS system? It is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Now what is the meaning of this line? It means mass of water is 1 gram for volume 1 centimeter cube, right? Now we are going to convert this gram and centimeter cube into kg and meter cube. We knew that 1 gram is equals to 1 by 1000 kg, and 1 centimeter means 1 by 100 meter. But here is centimeter cube. It means centimeter into centimeter into centimeter. So we have to convert accordingly. So 1 centimeter cube is equals to 1 by 100 into 100 into 100 meter cube. Now we are going to put this value in that formula, that is D is equals to M by V. In place of M we will write 1 by 1000 kg, and in place of V we will write 1 by 100. See, I have shown here by my handwritten paper that 1 by 1000 upon 1 by 100 into 1 by 100 into 1 by 100 meter cube. So the denominator became like a reciprocal number, so it is 1 by 1000 into 100 by 1 into 100 by 1 into 100 by 1. There are 3 zeros in numerator, that is cancelled. So remaining thing is 1000 kg per meter cube. What does it mean? It means that density of water in SI system is 1000 kg per meter cube, while density of water in CGS system is what? 1 gram per centimeter cube. Similarly, we can take some example of other liquids or solids also. Here I have shown you two examples of liquid. Like density of milk in CGS unit is 1.03 gram per centimeter cube. If the question will ask you that convert into SI unit or into kg per meter cube, what you have to do? You just multiply by 1000, it will be converted into kg meter per cube. If question will ask you that convert the given data which is given in kg per meter cube, convert into gram per centimeter cube, then what you will do? Then you will divide it by 1000. Okay, so second example is density of alcohol in CGS unit is equals to 0.8 gram per centimeter cube. I hope this line is clear. It means that mass of 1 centimeter cube alcohol is 0.8 gram. So density of alcohol in SI unit is equals to 0.8 into 1000 kg per meter cube, that is equals to 800 kg. Now In this slide, I have shown you two solid items. One is iron and second one is wood. When we compare the densities of two substances, for example, here if you see that size of wood, that is volume of wood, is more as compared to volume of iron. But if you will think about their masses, definitely you will be thinking that mass of iron must be more than mass of wood. So what I want to say here, that when we compare the densities of two substances, we compare the masses of two bodies of same volume. That's the idea of relative density. Now we will learn about relative density. What is it? Relative density of substances defined as the ratio of density of the substances and density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. It is denoted as RD, capital RD. So as a formula we can write down as follows: relative density of any substance is equals to density of substance divided by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. That is also equals to mass of any volume of substance divided by mass of same volume of water at 4 degrees Celsius. For example, if my question asks me that find the relative density of kerosene oil, if density of kerosene oil and density of water is given, so how will find that? Or if mass of kerosene oil and mass of same volume of water is given, then how will find out? So what we'll do, we'll write that relative density of kerosene oil is equals to density of kerosene oil divided by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Or if masses are given for same volume, then we will write relative density of kerosene oil is equals to mass of maybe 1 liter volume of kerosene oil or half liter volume of substance divided by mass of 1 volume of 1 liter or half liter. This data will be same, volume will be same, mass of 1 liter of water at 4 degrees Celsius. In this way we will find out relative density of any substance. Now question arises that why density of water is taken as standard value. So answer is very simple, that as water is the most commonly used substance, so it is. So I have shown the picture. You also draw the diagram in your notebook. And standard value of density of water at 4 degrees Celsius in CGS system is 1 gram per centimeter cube. So for relative density, density of substance is compared with density of water. Time and again you will write the same thing. Everywhere, wherever you have to find out relative density, you will write density of that substance divided by density of water. Okay. Now we will think about unit of relative density. As I have discussed in my first slide, that if we are going to find unit of anything, like there we have discussed about unit of density, and here we are going to discuss about relative density, you think about the formula of the quantity. So what is the formula of relative density? It is equals to density of a substance upon density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. It means if we will write the unit of both the things, density of substance, that will be in kg per meter cube, and similarly in denominator also, that is also in kg per meter cube. So overall both cancel, so there is no unit. That is the way, in that way you can memorize that there is no unit of relative density, because it is the ratio of two physical quantities, and though both are having the same unit, so both are cancelled, so there is no unit. It is a scalar quantity. Now in my next slide, I'm going to show you instrument used to find relative density of. So here is diagram of relative density bottle. It is a small glass bottle which has a stopper with a fine hole. This bottle is used to measure the mass of the bottle of equal volume of liquids. Okay. Now, with the help of an activity, I am going to explain you a measurement of density of fluid by using relative density bottle. So here you can see the diagram there is one relative density bottle and one physical balance is there. So step 1, clean and dry the relative density bottle and weigh it with the help of physical balance and mark it as M1. So mass of empty bottle is equals to M1. After that, step 2, fill it with the liquid up to the brim whose density has to be measured. Push the stopper gently in the neck of the bottle. Extra liquid coming out of it should be cleaned properly, because if we are not going to clean it, then there must be incorrect measurement of the mass, because that mass include mass of that liquid which is on outside wall of the bottle. So for precaution, it is compulsory that please clean all the extra liquids which is coming out of the bottle. Step 3, weigh the bottle containing liquid on the same physical balance and note down it as M2. So M1 was what? That was mass of empty bottle, and M2 is what? Mass of empty bottle plus liquid. So what is the mass of liquid? That is equals to M2 minus M1. So now let's see the calculation part. Here, as I have explained you that mass of empty bottle is equals to M1. You may consider any other symbol also, that is your choice. Mass of bottle plus liquid is equals to M2. Therefore, mass of liquid is equals to M2 minus M1. And volume of bottle, which is already marked on your bottle, density bottle, relative density bottle, you note down that thing. Therefore, density of that liquid is equals to mass of liquid upon volume of the liquid, that is equals to M2 minus M1 upon V. Very soon we will solve numericals based on these formulae. And here is the table, density values of some substances given. Children, this page is from your book only, your course book, and I think that page number is 25. I love to see this table in your notebook. Here, density in gram per centimeter cube, in kg per meter cube is given. Even relative density is also given. Even you may compare few data, like if someone will ask you what is the relative density of milk, you just divide density of milk with density of water, then you will get the answer as relative density of milk or water. That is the way by which you can cross check the formula of relative density. Even very soon I am going to solve sums based on it. Okay children, bye bye.